Ohio. Okay, 2 minutes po. Pwede mo pang CR. Nawala ng 2 minutes. Sige po. Okay, so habang... pwede po bang... pakipakanti po natin yung mga space po sa unahan? Kasi daw po yung nasa unahan, yun po yung unang nakakatanggap ng blessing.
Ayan, sino gusto?
Baka maghagis dito, di nasa unahan po yung... So, i-occupy niyo po yung mga nasa
unahan.
Okay na? Ready na tayo? So, bago po ako mag-start, take ko po yung opportunity na makapag-testimony po muna. So, ito po yung verse natin for this morning. So, Lamentation 3 verse 23 to 24.
Tayo po nasa likod, mauna po tayo. Nasa likod po, muna po tayo.
Settle down.
Napaka-best.
Sana lang po in-enter natin yung nasa likod.
Eh, wala na. Sorry. Ako pala. Sorry po.
O sige, habang hinihintay po natin, i-welcome muna natin yung ano, yung galing po ng vacation. Welcome back po kay Pastor Ronnie. Tsaka kay Sister Aileen po. Welcome back po sa inyo. At tsaka kay Sister Geneva po. Welcome back din. Nakita po namin kayo ulit dito. So, ang verse po natin this morning from comes from the Lamentation chapter 3 verse 23 to 24. There are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. I say to the Lord is my portion. Therefore, I will not put my hope in you. Amen. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. Amen. So, start ko muna po sa living testimony na po para tinawag masyadong muna. So, may papakita po ako sa inyong picture. Yan.
Uy,
trabaho. Mga fresh na fresh po kami dyan.
Si Kuya dyan pala yan. Si Kuya dyan pala yun.
So, kami po, sa yung po, nag-devotion po sa yung kapit po ako. So, nagkaroon po ako ng revelation because nag-connect po yung sinabi ni Pastor Ed na si Sister Bernice po yung decade. Yung dekada ng UPM. So, nagsalita ng gano'n si Pastor Edward, ayun yung picture na pre-repair ko. Actually, nung sinabi po sa akin ng admin to start this, ikaw yung MC. Actually, sabi ko, ako na naman, pero hindi. Yung pala ulit ako i-assign. So, as a servant po ng Lord na tumayo sa inyong harapan, may mga shortcoming po tayo at hindi po tayo righteous sa harapan ng Lord. But only the grace of God and mercy ng God kaya po tayo nakakatayo sa harapan niya. Amen. So, eto pong picture na to. Fresh na fresh pa po kami dyan. So, si... Lahat po kami dyan ay single except kay Brother Dennis na nagmamagod. Ako nanonood dyan. Papanoorin niya yung YouTube. Si Brother Dennis, si Brother Jans, na represent. Si Pastora Sherry, si Brother Mark. ang iyong likod at si Brother Coco. So, great is your faithfulness talaga. Na simula nag-start kami, kami-kami pa lang sa kanan. Wala pa yung iba dyan na hindi pa nagigising para makapag-church. Wala pa siguro yata dyan sina Sir Bernice. Parating pa lang, mga hinahire pa lang sila sa kanan nun. So, kami po ay mga single. Bakit ko po pinakita yung picture na yan? Gusto ko pong maging inspirasyon nyo kami sa tulong po ng Panginoon, sa kapurihan po ng Panginoon. Ayan po, si Sister Cristel po, naging forever na si Brother John. So ayan po, payat ang payat siya ngayon, triple na siya ngayon. So si Sister Cristel, fresh na fresh, diba? So, ayan po, maging naging forever namin. So si Sister, ako po si Brother ko. So, kita niyo naman ang mga title statistics namin dyan, diba?
Hey!
Ito ba yan? To make it my short story short, si Sister Sherry, pamating pa lang yung kanyang forever. Si Brother Frankie, ayun din, pinagpe-pray na yung kanyang forever din. At si Brother Dennis, matagal na yung may forever. So, alam niyo po ba kung ano yung blessing ng Lord aside na kami ang mga nagkatuluyan? Dahil sa mula noon hanggang ngayon kami ay patuloy na naglilingkod sa Panginoon. Amen.
Amen.
Nawala man si Brother Dennis at si Brother Mark, pero nasa man sila ngayon, nagpapatuloy pa rin sila sa Panginoon. What I'm trying to say is, alam niyo po ba kung ano yung blessing na nakuha namin sa Panginoon? Dahil mula na hanggang ngayon, magkakasama kami at nagpupuri kami sa Panginoon. Kami po ay nagkaroon ng malaking blessing.
Si Jacob.
Yun. So nagkaroon po kami ng mga wonderful children, Jacob, baby Jana, and baby Juan. At meron din pong bagong baby si Brother Dennis. Yun po yung greatest gift namin sa Panginoon. Amen! So yun yung reward namin na mula noon hanggang ngayon kami nagsiserve sa Lord. Amen! So, though in relationship namin bilang married, dati po kami mga single, mga youth ng GICM, ngayon po kami ay mga open married na kami po ay talagang truly blessed ng God. Amen! So, yung mga anak po namin ngayon, talagang kaloob po sa amin ng Panginoon. Though in marriage life, hindi talaga madali. Amen! So, take to this opportunity, next month po, sa kapurihan ng Panginoon, 5 years anniversary namin ni Brother Coco. Okay? Hindi man naging madali, talagang sabi nga sa daanan, malubak, malaking mga humps. Amen. But kasama natin ang Panginoon. Amen. So in 5 years, marami pong nangyari. So nandyan na nakunan din ako. So hindi naging madali. But then, hindi namin inayaan na mawalay kami sa Panginoon. Still, ang buhay natin ay mag-serve na sa Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So, I hope na yung mga youth dito, maging forever nyo din talaga yung pinagpe-pray. Actually, marami. Sa puno din kami nagpapapicture. So, makita nyo naman mga fresh na fresh pa kami dyan. Amen. So, next picture po is...
Hindi,
okay. So, nung umuwi po kami, galing vacation, May 13, pag-uwi namin po election, di namin alam. So, ito po yung Bacoor Municipal. Ang amin pong Vice Mayor si Danny Mercado. And the rest po. And Pastor Mike is one of the councilor of Bacoor City. Ito po. So, I'm not lifting any one of the member of the municipal para sila ay mag-glorify. But the living testimony po is Pastor Mike, naging counselor po siya. Like, ito po, this last term niya na po, this year. So, last term niya na. So, living testimony po, Pastor Mike is sharing the word of God talaga noon nag-start siya. Nagkakasal lang po siya sa munisipyo. Until na nabigyan po siya ng Panginoon ng opportunity naging counselor po siya. Nung pagdating po namin, talaga po ang bako or ang news dyan ay masyadong madugo talaga. In terms of prediction, ikakabayaran, talagang medyo madumi talaga ang kalakaran dyan. Talagang pera. So, nung election po, wala po silang kalaban. So, instant, panalo po silang lahat. Alam niyo po ba ang pinag-aawayan nila nung dumating kami? Yung sa mga counselor po, ang pinag-aawayan nila yung quest ng maging number one. Number one. So, yung tatlo po dyan, talagang nag-uus po sila ng pera, naglabas sila ng pera, million po talaga. At talagang tutukan po ang kanilang bigayan. And then May 13, so Pastor Mike talagang nakapastig siya. So, ang congregation that time may prayer meeting, so nagpe-pray kami. Kung ano kalooban ng Lord. Kasi hindi naman natin in-expect na kung ano din kasi panalo na silang lahat eh. Alam niyo po ba, in May 13 na nag-arrive kami ni Brother Gokoy, wala kami alam, 2 o'clock in the morning, pinatawag silang lahat. At tapos na po ang counting. And you know, talagang kung ikaw ay faithful sa Panginoon, God is faithful din sa Lord. And nalala ko si Joseph sa buhay ng father ko, or si Pastor Paul. Si Joseph po, ginawa siyang hari, di ba? Na yung mga kapatid niya hindi naniniwala sa kanya. Pinagpili siya. Si Papa meron siyang 13 na kapatid. Ganun sila karami. So, dalawa lang doon ang Kristiyano, the rest po Iglesia ni Cristo at Jehovah. So, talagang meaning to say, talagang maraming nag-persecute sa kanya. Pero hindi siya pinanginahan. Pagkos pinakita niya na si God lang ang kayang buwa ng lahat ng bagay at kanyang gawing number one. Amen. And then, 2 o'clock in the morning po, May 13, bali May 14 na yan, in-announce na po ng Comelec. At talagang, God is good po, na hindi naman hinahangad ni Pastor Mike, siya po ang naging number one with the 500 volts na lamang niya. And, Strike Revilla, brother of Bong Revilla, tinawagan niya si Pastor Mike, sabi niya, Pastor Mike, I'm so happy and grateful na ikaw ang nilagay ng Panginoon. Hindi mo ba alam na nag-away-away sila dahil sa posisyon number one? At ginulat sila ng Panginoon na ang naging number one ay si Pastor. Is it God is faithful?
Amen.
Amen. So, hindi niya hinahangad yan ni Pastor Mike. But in behalf of Pastor Mike, we are living testimony na wala kaming ibang naging buhay kundi mag-serve lang sa kanya. Yung nasa ganyan mo siyang posisyon, pero lagi ang kanyang, every Monday po kasi may program sa munisipyo, session, palagi niya nang nililid yung mga tao into prayers. Pinabasahan niya ng memory verse. Kahit na ang tingin sa kanya, yun naman si God, si Lord, ay, wala na ginawa, di ba Bible? Palagi na ng prayer. But see, ang tao na ang naglagay. Eh, matalino na po ngayon ang tao. Amen! So, talagang sabi ko, Lord, kung nagtatanim kami, aalilin mo talaga. Amen. So, ipapakita sa iyo ng Panginoon yung mga great and mighty things. Amen. Yung mga imposible talaga, ibibigay talaga sa iyo ng Panginoon. So, hindi lang po siyang naging pinagpala ng Panginoon, maging kami rin yung mga anak. Amen. So, marami ngayon natulungan sa munisipyo. Amen. So, mahirap kasi sa munisipyo na wala kang kakilala. Talaga, ang hirap makakuha ng tulong. But then, Pastor Mike, nilagay siya ng Panginoon doon para may purpose ng Panginoon. Amen. So, to God be the glory. I think it is the best practice of God's Panginoon. So, start na po tayo sa ating announcement po. Worship service ng ating pong preacher for today is Pastor Elder Ronnie Domingo. Ang ating pong closing benediction po, Pastor Dennis Cantos. And worship leader po, Brother Norman Jimenez, Asher and Asheret po, Grace Angels Ministry, Praise and Worship headed by UPN Agape Worship Team. At tayo opening po ang inyong sermon. And may prayer meeting po tayo after the service po. Okay, so yung mga mobile po natin na kung hanggat maaari po ang ta-turn off natin, i-turn off muna natin. So, ibigay natin ang bumbu, yung ating isipan, puso natin sa Panginoon. Yung mga burden natin, pwede natin iwan sa labas. So, yung mga cellphone po, for sure, mga pag-intayan mamaya. So, reserve po natin later. So, gonna invite everyone po mag-scripture reading sa tayo from the Book of Psalms, chapter 89, verse 38 to 45. 38, you have rejected and you have spurned and you have been very angry with your anointed one. 39. You have broken through all his walls and reduced his strongholds to ruins.
All who pass by have slandered him. He has become the scorn of his neighbors.
You have exalted the right hand of his spouse. You have made all his enemies rejoice.
Indeed, you have turned back the edge of his sword and you have not supported him in battle.
44. You have put an end to his splendor and cast his throne to the ground. Altogether, 45.
You have cut short the days of his youth, and you have covered him with the mantle of shame. To God be the glory.
So, my late na expectation lamang po doon sa binasa natin. So, aking pong pagkakaintindi doon, God is God of control of everything. Na po, na nandun po yung meron pong isang hari na naitalaga doon at ang Panginoon kapag nakikita niya yung namumuno ay hindi sumusurrender o hindi in-honor ang Panginoon. Talagang siya rin ang gumagawa ng way para mawala ang tao sa kanyang pamumuno. Amen. Diba? Kaya po tayo meron tayong pinagpe-pray yung ating presidente sa Pilipinas, di ba po? And the rest, vice president and the senators, na i-guide sila ng Panginoon. Na yung presidente natin, iba man ang kanyang religion, but then, yung respect niya sa Panginoon. Amen. Na ang isa pong namumuno, kapag may takot sa Panginoon, amen, na pagpapala po ang kanyang bansa. But this verse po na binasa natin, yung namumuno po dyan, talagang inalis po siya ng Panginoon. Hinayaan ng Panginoon sa battlefield na sila ay matalo. Amen. At the further explanation po, may mga verse pa po susunod. So, sa Tyson offering po tayo, may small na video clip na po tayo. So, hindi po na po ako mag-exhort sa Tyson offering, may video po tayo. So, pay attention po tayo kasi yun na po yung revelation ng God sa ating pong pagbibigay. But, lights off muna po.
Trust of a child, a son.
nations do within as you will. I surrender.
Are we feeling blessed?
Amen.
God priesthood?
All the time.
Grabe. All the time, guys. Sabi ko nga po eh, blessed are those who take refuge in Him. I happened to come across one image while browsing in YouTube. So, I was inspired by seeing one of the images. So, that's why po, ito yung ating presentation. Mahilig ko ba kayo mag-travel? Sa mga places na kayo nakapag-travel? Yung about nature po, have you been to Boracay, Palawan? Have you seen the wonders and beauty of the beaches, of the mountains? So, let's zoom it out a little bit further, outside the country. Sa UAE perhaps. Sa Oman, nakapagdahan. Sa Europe. Ano namin mga nakita natin? Like sa Egypt, isang pa tayo na nakapagdahan. Well, the desert is...
Fail.
Well, it's man-made, pero... We're trying to appreciate the beauty of nature. And let's zoom it out a little bit further. And see this. So, seeing this, anong masasabi mo kayo? Or anong nakikita mo? Seeing this image. Like, wow, it's maganda. Oh, nandiyan tayo sa loob. Lahat tayo, nandiyan tayo ngayon. Lahat ng kilala natin, lahat natin sa Diyos. Nandiyan ngayon. This part, well, this brown part, yan yung Middle East, diba? Yung peninsula. This is India, that is Sri Lanka. This is Africa. That is Philippines. Kita mo ba? Philippines, nasa Far East. So, imagine this image. It was taken from a satellite. If this is the Earth, this is the satellite. Itong Earth, this is the satellite. At yung position, then he took a snapshot. Wow, this is the image. So, let's zoom it out a little bit further.
Ayun. Moon na yan.
So, this was taken during Apollo 8, I think. So, yung first Apollo mission na nakarating sa buwan. So, Neil Armstrong was there. So, 1969. Anong napipin mo sa picture nito? Medyo malayo. Ganda, no? Sabi nga ng isang astronaut, I can cover the Earth with just the tip of my thumb. It's so small. Pero, we still see the beauty and wonder ng creation. Let's zoom it out further. Mahilig ba kayo sa astronomy?
Yes.
Familiar kayo dun sa mga planets?
Yes.
So, what is the fourth planet from the sun? Third po tayo, Earth. Yeah, it's the red planet. So, there are three dots. This is taken from the surface of Mars. By one of the Mars rovers. I don't know the name, unfortunately. So, yung other two dots na yun, ito yung two moons na Mars, Phobos and Deimos. And then, the other dot, the bigger of the three dots, it's not star, it's the Earth. Kung kanina, kaya natin i-cover ng top natin, this one. It's just a dot. This was taken, I think, 2003, when we sent out, or something like that, when we sent out the two rovers. So, way back 1976, after the successful missions na pagpadala natin ng tao sa Luna, nagpadala rin tayo ng spacecraft called the Voyager. So, yung Voyager na dito na yun, kakabahayan itong drum set natin, na meron siyang silver disc. Lahat ng information about the Earth is nilagay doon. So, it's made of copper. So, 1976, it was launched to see the beauty of the outer planets, which is Jupiter and Saturn. And by the time of 1990, this picture was taken in the 1990s. when it was in the near the or past the orbit of Neptune, which is the eighth planet from the Sun. And what can you see? What can you see on this picture? There's a band of light, and there is a small dot. That dot is Earth. Everything you know of, lahat ng mga mahal natin sa buhay, nandiyan. May gusto kong sabihin sa Saturn?
Yung mic is over there.
And nagkaroon ng realization sa araw na. Importante ba tayo? Isang dot lang yan, no? It's just a mere speck. It's a dust. It's an insignificant pixel on that digital image. Actually, zoom out ano na yan, the image. Very insignificant. Everything we know. Zoom out further. They are here. Or we are here.
Yes.
Very small. So, perspective, yan yung ano, picture past the eight planets. It's very far. 6 billion kilometers. Hindi ko ma-imagine kung ano yung 6 billion. Di ba? So, matanong ko lang, are we significant? Pero, sabi ng God, we are special. Iko-quote ko lang, meron akong nakita kasi na remark from one of the scientists or astronomer during that time. His name is Carl Sagan. He's not a Christian or Catholic. He calls himself like a atheist. So, he believes in something, but he's not atheist. So, on his one of his talks in the University of US, he described this image as a pale blue dot. And he described it that that's here, that's home, that's us. On it, everyone you ever heard of, every human being who ever lived out their lives. The aggregate of all our joys and sufferings, thousands of confident religions, ideologies, and economic doctrines, every hunter and forager, every hero and coward, every creator and destroyer of civilizations, every king and peasant, every young couple in love, every hopeful child, every mother and father, every inventor and explorer, every teacher of morals, every corrupt politician, every superstar. So to cut the short story, everything that you can think of that happened in your life, it's there on that small speck of dust, floating in space. Very insignificant. Pero sabi ni God, di ba, I created you in my own image. That makes you special. From Psalm 139, O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know my sitting down and my rising up. You understand my thought afar off. You comprehend my path and my lying downs. And are acquainted with all my ways, for there is not a word on my tongue. But behold, O Lord, you know it altogether. He knows his plans for us. Lahat ng nangyayari sa buhay natin, God has planned for us. He even gave us His only Son, His only begotten Son. And if we feel that we're special, we give up. It's all like that. Kaya po, let us pray, pasalamatan po natin ang Lord sa lahat ng blessings na ito. Father, we thank you every day. We thank you for the simplest things. We thank you sa morning na ito na nagising po kami. We thank you for the guidance and protection na karating po kami sa church. Thank you po for the love of our family and for our friends. Thank you for all the creations. Thank you for your anointing, Father. Thank you for the authority that you gave us to
to look over and to look after for all of your creations. From the smallest creatures here on earth to the biggest beast. From the deepest seas to the highest mountains. From the sweetest, the most colorful plants to the mightiest of towering trees. All of these wonderful creations, we can just look at all. How great you are, Father. Truly, Father, you are a great and awesome, wonderful God, and we can never thank you enough. All this, Father, all this praise and thanks, Father, we give it back to you. Kaya po mga kapatid, sama-sama po tayo tumawid para sa kanya. Let us all sing about God's awesomeness, how awesome our God is.
Thank you.
awit sa Panginoon. And let's continue to worship the Lord. And ipin po natin ang presence ng sa atin ng ating Panginoon Diyos.
Send me a place. I want to.
Muli po nakaka-bless talaga. Thank you to 31. God's Word. At magpapa nga tayo po yung manalangin. Father God, salamat Panginoon sa pagkakitong ito at that you gather this congregation, Panginoon, a congregation of believers, Panginoon, na pumakasa, Lord, sa iyong biyaya at sa iyong kapatihan, Panginoon. Lord, we seek your provisions this morning, your mercy, your wisdom, and your will, Panginoon. We know, Father God, that you have something for us this morning. We thank you for this time that in the next hour and so, we are able to look upon your words. And we pray that may you use your servant mightily, that I may be able to express your words, Panginoon, clearly, and that the congregation might benefit from it. Lord, fill this place with your love, and mga Panginoon, maghari po sa aming lahat ang kaliwanagan ng isipan, at ang magandang pag-isipan, Panginoon. Lord, we thank you and be with us at this time. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Meron po bang stand? Linawahan mo lang. Okay, so we have for today this preaching entitled What Old Testament Guidelines Still Apply. You know, the word Bible is so unique that it only applies to the Word of God, diba? To the Scriptures. And being the word Bible means composed ng dalawang parts, diba? Yung Old Testament and the New Testament. And we all know that the Bible is the best-selling book, diba? Kaya yung iba, who wants to sell their book in a big way, they put the word Bible. Diba? Like, computer Bible, mga ganun, diba? Cooking Bible. But they're not true to their word. Thank you, Brother Wilco. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, so today, nais ko pong girimin ang inyong pandinig, ang inyong atensyon as we look at the Bible, as the Bible, di ba? So, it could be a long study because we will be covering the Old Testament and the New Testament. Kinabahan na lahat. No, but I think God has a purpose this morning that we are able to understand some important issues or aspects of the Bible. And bakit ba ganun yung nature niya? Bakit mayroong Old Testament? At ano ba yung purpose ng mga katuluan doon? And paano siya ma-apply sa ating panahon? Sa ating time, di ba? Tayo na mga nasa... Ano ba ating age? 30s. Ah, yan. 30s. Panari yan. hindi millennial. Bilis. 30s. I know that my experience is like nearly 30 years. Yun ang sinasabi ng CD ko. Anyway, since we are covering this long study, so we have many verses to look at. I don't have a particular verse, but we are looking at Leviticus 18-19. Matthew 5:17-48, and Ephesians 6:1-3, and some verses from Colossians chapter 2:16-17. And for today, our proposition is that God has clear expectations for His children. As any good parent, some come as commands that are always true, and others are instructions for a particular time of life. Yung mga ating ano ngayon, proposition. And I would like to give credits to the author, Craig Hooker, sa part po ng sermon na ito. At truly, God is gracious at this is His will this morning. So, God's laws from the Old and New Testament are not just arbitrary expressions of His power. They're not random. And God does not make one thing up today and make up something contradictory tomorrow. Diba? The Mosaic Law, or the Law of Moses, of the Old Testament, it also pertains to the Torah and the first book of the Hebrew Bible. Kung saan, this Mosaic Law is comprised of at least 611 or 613 laws. It was written for the chosen people of Israel. So let me make a distinction between how the Israelites were chosen then and how we as Christians are chosen now, because it is relating to the purpose of the law and how we apply it today. So Israel was chosen for a purpose. I'm not moving my slides, sorry. Israel was chosen for a purpose. We read from Genesis 12:1-3. It's on the screen. They were God's instruments to accomplish a plan of rescue for the world. God becoming as a member of the Jewish race and dying on the cross for man's crimes against God. Take note, they were not chosen to be saved. Rather, they were chosen to be used to accomplish God's plan of salvation. Many of those Jews took advantage of the mercy offered through that plan. At gayon din, marami po, they went wayward. So hindi lahat talaga sumunod among the Jews. Israel's being chosen did not secure their salvation. Hindi porque sinabing Israel is a chosen nation or chosen race, ay ligtas na sila. No. Israel being chosen did not secure their salvation. It secured a salvation plan for the world. And whether they individually participated in it or not was another question. So, Christians are the chosen in the sense that those who are in Christ, putting their trust in Him, are the ones that benefited from that plan of salvation that God was working out through Israel. So we put our confidence in Him, so we are chosen regarding salvation. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever, because He is God. God doesn't change, but that doesn't mean that the way He deals with mankind doesn't change. God is unchanging. Pero yung kanyang pamamaraan in dealing with people actually changes. God dealt with Adam and Eve in one way, and then He dealt with the Jews through Abraham with a different plan. Yeah? So He deals with Christians now through a new plan, which is the new covenant. Yeah? So there was a unique relationship God had with the nation of Israel as part of the execution of the plan. So there is a unique kind of plan that He has in the new covenant that's expressed through Jesus and what He did on the cross. So you can see that God changes a lot of things, a lot of different things. And He can make plans and play things out so that certain things apply in some cases and don't apply later. Though His purpose and His though His purpose is very constant and it is unchanging. So that's the difference. His purpose is constant, it is unchanging, but His ways are actually changing. The Mosaic Covenant, or yung sinasabing the Law of Moses, is a treaty God made with the Jews, which is the nation of Israel. And you can ask, what is the purpose of Deuteronomy? Now, Deuteronomy is the second time the law is given. It is given the first time in Mount Sinai by Moses. Diba? Pero there were 40 years na kung saan sila ay they're wandering in the desert. They're so mobile. They're so nomads. Diba? And then after that, the first generation dies away. Anong sumunod? So here comes the new generation under Joshua. So Joshua, bago po namatay si Moses, he gives that same law again, a second time in Deuteronomy to the new generation. Because this new generation is meant to take the land and live according to this law as a nation. So the important thing is that this is an agreement that God made with Israel. It is not an agreement God made with anyone else. So, noting that nothing that is in the Mosaic Law or the Law of Moses applies to me as a Gentile in virtue of it being part of the law. No command is incumbent upon me in virtue of that being part of the law. So, what are we saying here? The Mosaic Covenant or the Law of Moses is like a state law. It was given to those people in that state for that period of time. Tayo naman, we are in a different state now. So we have a different covenant. Yeah? That applies to us, which is the new covenant with the different obligations. So that is the truth. We are not obliged by everything in the Mosaic Law. Take note of the word that we are not obliged by everything in the Law of Moses. That was a set of civil obligations that were applicable to those people in that nation. It was made between God, Moses, and Israel. So God took them out of the land. Diba? God rescued them out of Egypt. And they were obligated to Him as their sovereign. So, ano kanilang obligation? They had to keep the terms of the covenant. Dalawang direksyon yun. If they did, He would protect them. And if they didn't, He would forsake them. There's a verse from Deuteronomy 28:36-37, which read, "The Lord will drive you and the king you set over you to a nation unknown to you or your ancestors. There you will worship other gods, gods of wood and stone. You will become a thing of horror, a byword and an object of ridicule among all the peoples, where the Lord will drive you." So, the Jews were scattered abroad because they did not follow Him. They did not follow the terms of the covenant. So, from this slide, you will understand that at least they were scattered three times. So, you'll find the Jews everywhere. In fact, they don't have a valid country, right? So, this is subtitled Curses for Disobedience. So, you see, there are blessings and curses in the Mosaic Covenant meant for Israel. the Mosaic contract is no longer in force. Salamat sa Diyos, di ba? It's no longer in force. The law of Moses is no longer in force in our time. It has been replaced for everyone, including Jews, by the new contract. The new contract is a new enterprise. Gentiles were never under the old contract. Now, Jews and Gentiles alike who put their faith in Jesus are under the contract. Di ba? So yung ano, yung old contract, yung old covenant, it was meant for the Jews. Pero hindi naman lahat ng Jews ay sumampalataya. But the new covenant is actually para sa Jews and para sa Gentiles na rin. Di ba? This is the new contract. Now, does that mean that I can go around murdering people because we're not under the law of Moses? No. The obligation not to murder is a universal and should be in any law, just as our law does. The Mosaic law included, this is the key word, it included universal moral principles. So we are obligated to follow those moral rules, not in virtue of them being in the Mosaic law, but because they are universal for all people. So the Mosaic law included universal moral rules and rules that were limited to the nation who live under that contract. So we have to distinguish between this as we consider how we relate to the Mosaic covenant now. Diba? So I hope you're not bored. It was just full of expressions and full of readings. But these are very important statements that we have to learn from. Universal moral obligations from the Mosaic Law are repeated in the New Testament. This is another important statement. Universal moral obligations from the Law of Moses are repeated in the New Testament. And the things that no longer apply to us are not repeated in the New Testament. For example, love God with all your heart and love your neighbor as yourself are both in the New and in the Old Testament. This is a summary statement in the New Testament. So part of it was in response to the Jews. Actually, it was hard to keep all the laws. Mahirap po. Diba, we said kanina, 613 laws. And if you go back sa Leviticus, ay, mahirap po siya. It was a difficult law. So, they decided, let's keep the most important one. Yun na parang lay. So there were debates between them about which law was the greatest commandment. So they asked Jesus. The purpose of finding the greatest commandment was to focus on keeping that really well. Gusto nyo lang tukoyin, ano ba yung greatest commandment? At kapag natukoy yun, then yun ang ating gustong tuparin. Parang ganun, di ba? And then, not worry so much about the others. So Jesus says, you don't have to worry about the rest of the commandments if you can fulfill this. But take note. Love your God with your whole heart, soul, mind, and strength. And love your neighbor as yourself. Then, ito na naman yung lawyer. Sabi niya, same person who raised that question, seeking to justify himself. He asked who his neighbor is. Ano pong sagot ni Jesus? Jesus responded with the parable of the Good Samaritan, which points even your enemies are your neighbor. So, the lawyer is interested in finding a way that he can work out his own salvation out by himself. So the problem with people is people insist to justify himself, but he cannot. Diba? I think you have gone through EE last week. Part ito ng turo, diba? You cannot justify yourself by your own works. Never. So Jesus is emphasizing the complete impossibility of self-justification, which is the fundamental difference between the Old Covenant and the New Covenant. So the nation of Israel was obliged to obey the laws of their nation in order to reap God's blessings or curses. So, now we can see that the Old Testament, yung kanilang pagtupad dito, it was based on obedience. Because they wanted to reap yung benefit ng pagsunod. At yung opposite end niya is yung curses naman, di ba? Sa hindi pagsunod. So, ang difference niya is that the New Covenant is based on grace. Yeah. Old Testament, based on obedience. The New Testament is based on a grace, not obedience. So, the two laws are completely different. So that the way they apply to us are different. Bakit na napaka-importante yung verse na yun about your neighbor, that you love your neighbor as yourself? When Jesus is talking about loving your neighbor, He is not advancing it as a separate ethic. He is saying this sums up the obligation of the Old Testament law. It is meant to be a further burden on anyone that is seeking to justify himself. So if you are justifying yourself, ito yung burden sa'yo. Ano sabi ni Jesus? Love your neighbor as yourself. It's something that you cannot really do for a long term. You cannot. You cannot love your neighbor as yourself. So, then you have to face this situation. You're not going to be able to consistently treat your neighbor this way. Therefore, conclusion on, you cannot justify yourself. You know, kasi yun ang terms ni Jesus eh. Today, we do not live under the law of Moses or the Mosaic Covenant. We don't have all the laws that pertain to dietary and sacrificial things because Jesus did away with those laws. We don't have the punishments prescribed in the law because that was for their judicial system in that nation. So we don't apply those punishments since we are not under the system of laws. Now, the challenge is in our time, most Christians are being na sabi, you follow, I think, the challenge. You are following some of the rules in the Bible, and you tend to ignore others. Yun yung charge ng iba, di ba? Mga non-believers. And the line goes like this. When the Bible talks about certain sexual behaviors as sin, you quote the Bible. Di ba? Ganun yung iba. But when it says not to eat shellfish, or that you should execute people for breaking the Sabbath, you just ignore it. So yun yung charge ng iba, mga non-believers, that some Christians are double standard. When it's convenient, you quote that Bible verse. When it's not, you ignore them. So this is the challenge. Yeah? So, ang tanong sa inyo is, are you just picking and choosing what suits you best? This is the question. Right? So let's go to the Old Testament book which are the most often quoted to slam Christians. The first one being, some Old Testament passages clash with modern society. You know, the Bible calls for sex to be a unique and wonderful intimacy between a man and a woman joined in marriage. Pero ano po ang pinaportray ng ating society, ng ating telenovela? Diba, ang ating nakita doon is, that the first thing that couple do, kapag item na sila, the first thing they do is make love. Yun ang pinaportray ng society ngayon. So when you glance down at Leviticus, now we go back sa Old Testament, which is, if you open the Leviticus in 18, you'll find there so many law about sexual practices, characters. Ano sabi dito? Do not have sexual relations with a man as one does with a woman. That is detestable. So, nung time na yun, nung time nila Moses, nangyayari yun. Kasi bakit sasabihin yung law na yan kung hindi nangyayari, di ba?
bakit sila pagbabawalan sa bagay na yun? So nangyayari ito. So imagine at that time, kaya lumabas yung mga ganitong law. And that was the time of Moses. Go further from Leviticus 19:19. Keep my decrees. Do not mate different kinds of animals. Do not plant your field with two kinds of seed. Do not wear clothing woven of two kinds of material. Parang weird sa ating time, di ba? It cannot. Di po pwede. So it just means that some Old Testament passages clash with the modern society. The question is, what are we to do with these Old Testament commands? Di ba? Next point. Some Old Testament passages embarrass us today. Ano pong sabi sa Leviticus 19:27? Do not cut the hair at the sides of your head or clip off the edges of your beard. If you follow this, so bawal lang gubit binata, di ba? We will be all like, if you see the movie Tom Hanks, yung Castaway, kung gano'ng kahaba yung buhok niya, yung buhok. Because you cannot cut the sides of your head. If you look at this verse, di ba? So this kind of verse, it embarrasses us today. In fact, there are more. There is a lot more. Add to that commands like the punishment of death for adultery. You'll find this in the Old Testament. Or for cursing your parents. These are an embarrassment to the modern mind. We are being mocked today, even though we don't do them. Yeah. We don't do these kind of things. But when somebody, an unbeliever, lift this up, raise this up to you, you feel embarrassed. So if you don't know what to answer, you will really feel embarrassed how to defend yourself as a Christian. So what are we to do with these Old Testament passages or commands? Next, some Old Testament passages clash with current Christian practices. For example, the food laws of the Old Testament are not ones that the Christian church keeps today. Di ba? It's so common naman. We eat bacon, ham, shrimps, lobster. So, which were forbidden for the Jewish people in the Old Testament? You can check that in chapter 11 of Leviticus. As an example, you know the Seventh-day Adventist church? They keep the Old Testament dietary laws. Hindi mo sila basta, I remember having a visitor at home na member ko ng Seventh-day Adventist. At hindi na nila alam. So yung mga pagkain, ay hindi nila makain. So pa sila, wala sila makain. Kasi dahil sa kanilang practice ng kanilang dietary law. They still practice that. At alam niyo yan, di ba, kung kakain ka ng isda, kailangan may kaliskis, kung gano'n ba? Or kung yung, maraming iba, hindi ko malala yun. Ay, nabiyak yung paa, yun. So, these are the times when Bible-believing Christians told that they are not good Christians because they don't keep the Old Testament food laws or the festivals or meeting for worship on Saturday. Again, brothers and sisters, what are we to do with these Old Testament commands? Lastly, some Christians don't believe any Old Testament commands apply to us today. Now, they claim that the New Testament, that we are not under the law. Means that none of the Old Testament commands apply to us. They say the Mosaic law is like state law. So they say, since we are not under the Old Covenant, but under the New Covenant, none of these Old Testament commands apply to us. May mga ganun pong kaisipan. May mga ganun pong kaisipan. Now, the way to interpret and understand the Old Testament is to look at it in light of the New Testament. I have a few points here. The first one being, Jesus fulfilled the law from Matthew 15:17-18. Three simple truths here. Jesus holds the Old Testament in highest esteem. It is not a lesser or inferior covenant. Hindi naman po ano eh, when Jesus came, He did not just throw away the old covenant, or He did not, hindi niya binasura. In fact, He elevated and fulfilled it. Finally, Jesus isn't getting rid of the law in His fulfilling, but it expects obedience and teaching the commands to future generations. But there is more. Jesus fulfilled the law. This is the continuation of the verse. And then the next item is Jesus declared all fruits clean. This is from Mark 7, 14 to 19. We learn from the New Testament that some of the Old Testament laws were a physical picture so we could understand a deeper spiritual truth that is fulfilled in Jesus. Let's take the Old Testament command about food. In Mark 7, Jesus explains to the disciples that the unclean foods in the Old Testament, like pork, bacon, and shrimp, were not unclean because of their nature, but it was a picture of how sin defiles us. So Mark 7:19 says, in saying this, Jesus declared all foods clean. Yeah. So after He had left the crowd and entered the house, His disciples asked Him about this parable. Are you so dull? He asked. Don't you see that nothing that a person that enters a person from the outside can defile them? For it does not go into their heart, but into their stomach, and then out of the body. In saying this, Jesus declared all foods clean. So, when you are asked or questioned about food laws or food practices, this is the answer. All foods have been declared by Jesus as clean. Christians are not under the food law of the Old Testament, because we now see those deeper spiritual lessons more clearly in the life of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus, the sacrificial system at temple was fulfilled. Matthew 27:51 states that the temple curtain separating the holiest of holy from all humans, even priests, was ripped in two at Jesus' death. This is because Jesus' death on the cross fulfilled the sacrificial system commanded in the Old Testament. You know, the temple veil or the curtain, I was shocked to understand that this is like 60 feet high and 30 feet wide. At yung kapal niya is like 4 inches. Ganito po yung kapal niya, 4 inches. It was woven fabric. So, with this size, no person can tear it apart. Yeah? And, in fact, to place that curtain, they needed 30 priests para i-manipulate yung curtain na yun. Now, this curtain is the screen between the unrighteous and the temple. Kaya yun lang yung access is the high priest. At the death of Jesus, actually Jesus, in fact, He was torn at His death. So this curtain was torn at His death, taking away the burden or the barrier in approaching God. So Christians have now the access to God, di ba? Through Jesus. So this sacrifices of animals are no longer needed by Christians because Jesus died once for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, as the book of Hebrews shares many times. Jesus strengthened the moral law. While Jesus eliminates the need for Christians to carry out the Jewish food regulations and all the ceremonies and sacrifices of the temple, Jesus does not eliminate the need for us to obey the moral laws found in the Old Testament. So we need to be careful about this. Although inalis ni Kristo, ni Christ, yung pagsunod sa mga food laws at saka sa mga iba pang ceremonial laws, ay hindi po niya inalis ang pagsunod sa universal moral laws. That always apply. He actually strengthens it. Just look at Matthew 5:21. You have heard that it was said to the people long ago, you shall not murder, and anyone who murders will be subject to judgment. But I tell you that anyone who is angry with a brother or sister will be subject to judgment. Again, anyone who says to a brother or sister, Raka, is answerable to the court. And anyone who says, you fool, will be in danger of the fire of hell. In fact, sa New Testament, when God repeated this moral command, dinagdagan pa niya. Diba? Kasi yung una is just about yung pag-murder. Ano yung sumunod? What it's saying here is kahit daw pala yung vengeful act at yung mga angry thoughts is subject to judgment. So we can see that Jesus did not cancel the moral laws. In fact, He strengthened them. Yeah, that is the thought. So, now, how can we tell? Paano mo nasabi? Paano mo nasabi, di ba? So, turn to Ephesians 6. I want us to see that the rest of the New Testament shows that we are still called to obey the Old Testament moral commands. Children, sabi dito, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with a promise. So, ito na yung ating sinasabi kanina. Jesus repeated in the New Testament those that are applicable, those that are relating to moral. Diba? This is what we were claiming kanina pa. And yung hindi na kailangan, yung hindi na importante, hindi na inulit sa New Testament. Paul quotes the Old Testament as the proof. So, not being under the law cannot mean that none of the Old Testament laws apply to Christians anymore. Because the writer who used that phrase clearly shows at least some of the Old Testament commands still apply to us. So it's not absolute, ano po? It's not absolute. The statement that says we are not being under the law means hindi mo pwedeng kalimutan yung mga moral laws. They still apply. Pero yung mga ceremonial tsaka yung mga food laws, yun, hindi na yun applicable sa atin. Now, the Old Testament food laws don't apply to Christians today, but not murdering and obeying your parents as Old Testament laws do. So, how is a Christian to know which other Old Testament commands apply and which don't today? Now, again, this has nothing to do with what is relevant or what is approved by your current culture. It's not related to culture. The Bible tells us that the Old Testament laws were given for a variety of purposes, including showing us our sin, seeing God's holiness, making God's chosen people distinct, pointing to the cross, dealing with sin, properly approaching God, making the Jewish society work, remembering God's greatest works in the past, and moral standards reflecting God's character. So, both Jews and Christians through the ages have categorized Old Testament commands to better understand them. This has led to the distinction between ceremonial law, judicial law, and the moral law. Now, at this point, I would like to distinguish ano ba yung kaibahan nun? Yung ceremonial laws, judicial laws, at saka yung moral law. Now, we repeat our statement kanina that the law of Moses or the Mosaic law is a difficult law. Mayroon po siya sundin. In fact, not many have followed them or fulfilled them. It is a difficult law. So, mamaya we will understand na why is the Old Testament difficult? At bakit yung ginawa ni Kristo ay nabura yun? Di ba? So, in that argument, you can appreciate kung ano yung ginawa ni Kristo, di ba? Yung value ng ginawa niya. Kasi yung mahirap na law, ating dapat tutuparin, binura niya yun. So, yun ang value ng ginawa ni Jesus Christ. Let's look at ceremonial laws which are fulfilled in Jesus' sacrifice. Alam niyo po ang ceremonial laws, it governed Israel's worship. These laws speak about what things are clean and unclean, and what sacrifices were to be offered, and how they were to be done. It's so detailed. The sacrificial system was the heart of the Old Testament worship. So in this Old Testament system, we are confronted with the massive problem of human sin, as well as the unbridgeable gap between humans and the Holy God. Kaya lang, but in God's grace, the Lord allowed animals to be sacrificed on our behalf, because this pointed towards Jesus and His perfect sacrifice on the cross, so that our sins will be forgiven forever. Why is Jesus called the sacrificial lamb? Yeah. So, praise God, dahil inalaw niya na i-sacrifice yung animals on our behalf. And this is like illustrated pa sa ginawa ni Kristo. So, Hebrews chapter 9 describes this, as well as the fact that since the ripping of the temple curtain at Jesus' death, those who repent and put their faith in Jesus can now go directly into God's presence. Kasi nung time na yun, wala nang maka-access sa throne of God. Kasi yung dahil sa curtain ng temple. Pero nung pagdating ni Kristo, na-separate na yun eh. So meron tayong access. This is what we gain from Jesus. We have direct access to God. Because Jesus' death once and for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, those ceremonial laws have been fulfilled totally. So we no longer have to do those. But they have so much to teach us, because they show us the death of Jesus' sacrifice. This is my argument kanina. Yung purpose nun is for us to appreciate yung value ng ginawa po ng ating Panginoon Jesus Cristo with His sacrifice of death in Calvary. Now, God's justice and mercy and our sin. Kaya nga po, Christians, please note this, don't do the ceremonial law, and even Jewish people haven't done most of them since the temple was destroyed nearly 2,000 years ago. So, gone away with ceremonial laws. Sa probinsya, may mga ano pa rin eh. Alam niyo, yung mga ceremonies pa rin na ginagawa yung ating mga oldies. If you have the boldness, sometimes we are able to ridicule or rebuke them. And I think this is our prayer, you know. We should rebuke those. Not in our own abilities, but we have to pray to God. Yeah? Next, ano po ba yung judicial? Now, we have covered yung ceremonial laws, which is fulfilled in Jesus' sacrifice. Now, these are the civil or judicial laws which is intended for the Jewish nation. The civil or judicial law are those commands specifically for the Jewish nation. They brought order to the land of Israel and helped leaders govern in a way that uniquely pointed to the true God in heaven. Civil or judicial law relate to agriculture, settlement of disputes, and what they were to eat, about cleanliness, about dressing, about festivals, and the various punishments for violating laws. Now these laws also provided a unique identity for the Israelites as people belonging to God. God asked the Jewish people to do these things simply so that they would be different. Because the Hebrews have kept most of this to this day, you will find Jewish people all over the world, even though they haven't had their own country the last 2,000 years. I don't know, but maybe you're also having this observation that Jewish people around the world, they are so distinct in the way they dress, in the way they behave, and their practices, because God made them so. This is what, and this is what was the intention. They should be distinct, because they were the chosen people. But you want, dahil ganun sila, they were molded in that shape. Unlike, kukumpara mo, halimbawa sa Americans, na, let's say, mag-disintegrate ang Amerika, dahil sa wala kong specific agreed-on practices, hindi mo po ma-differentiate ang American when you mix them with the Europeans or with other nations. Diba? So this is the difference among the Jewish people. They are distinct, they are unique. When Jesus came, He started a new entity, which is the church. Now, eto na. The church is for both Jew and non-Jew alike. So the civil laws of the Old Testament don't apply to the church. The civil laws of the Old Testament does not apply to the current church, because these Old Testament laws have always been for the ethnic Jewish people. So the church does not require to do a kosher diet. Among the Jews, they do yung kosher diet. Kosher diet is a means of preparing meat bago lutuin, wherein as much as possible they will take away all the blood from the meat. This is what they call a kosher diet. Kosher diet. Sa mga Muslim, they have ways of preparing meat. They call it halal. For the Jews, they have this way of preparing meat, and they call it kosher diet. So the early church made it clear new Christians did not need to first get circumcised to become Christians. Kasi noon, kailangan ma-circumcise ka muna bago ka maging Kristiyano. But for us, it's not necessary. But I suggest you do. Nakaisa rin ako. Nakaba na siya, seryoso masyado, no? Nakaisa rin siya. So, worship was not limited to Friday night until Saturday. Saturday until supper. You know the word Sabbath, even Sabbath. Among the Jews, that pertains to the evening of Friday hanggang gabi po ng Sabado. Yun yung sinasabing Sabbath. And that is holy sa Jews. Again, we earn incredible principles through the Old Testament civil commands like caring for the poor, dealing with offenses, and restitution. Check out Leviticus 19:13-18. Ito, may mga verse dito. You can read them while I discuss. The thing is, they don't apply to us anymore because Jesus has fulfilled them in a different way. Yeah. So, this judicial or civil laws is intended for the Jewish nation. It's not for us. It's not for Christians. Because Jesus fulfilled them. See, we have been talking about moral laws kanina pa, no? Now, we will focus on it at this point, which says, moral laws is actually for all humanity from creation. So finally, here we are. There were moral laws. Now, these commands deal with what God declares are right and wrong for all humans. They are based in the very character of God, so they are holy, just, and unchanging. They always apply to all peoples at all times and in all lands. The Ten Commandments, which is the best example that we can raise at this point. We are never to have any other gods, idols, or defame the name of God. That has always been true and will be true even after Jesus returns and stop the world from existing. When we obey these laws, our lives simply go better for the long run. Even though we may have more hassles at the moment in cultures which don't believe them. You will always find objection. There is always persecution from what we do and what we believe in. So there is hassle for this community that don't believe in these laws. That is what we are seeing with regards to biblical sexual values today. But if it is a moral law from God, from the Old Testament, you can be sure negative long-term problems will come to the church, to the cultures that reject them. Totoo, di ba? Yung mga hindi sumusunod sa katusan ng Diyos ay nagsasuffer sa mga ng long-term sa mga bagay po na kanilang dinideny sa ngayon. Although it may take 10, 20, 40 years to see, but it will be clear down the road. Remember, whenever Jesus mentioned the moral laws, he either reaffirmed them or intensified them. To follow Jesus is to love what he loved, and including the moral law. So, malina po, ano? Kanina nakita natin yung ceremonial laws. They were fulfilled in Jesus' sacrifice. Yung judicial law applied to the Jews. And the moral law, it applies to all. It applies to the church. Let's look at the principles. So how do we know what Old Testament commands? Rules or guidelines apply today. They all apply in terms of learning from them. This is the basic thought for this morning. How do we know what Old Testament commands, rules, or guidelines apply today? Well, as far as learning is concerned, all of this applies, the Old and the New Testament. But in terms of commands, we are to obey right now. We are to keep the moral Old Testament laws, but not the civil, not the ceremonial. Are there times na it might be hard for a person to distinguish whether a command is civil, ceremonial, or moral? Yes, ito po. Sometimes we will face this difficulty. Paano mo ba matitest kung yung command na yun is civil or ceremonial or moral? Because in the Old Testament, in the Jewish laws, they blended together. Naghalo na po. So it's difficult to distinguish. Now, there is this process which is called look at the principle, which is a deeper process than we can describe here. I'll give you an example. The fourth commandment, which is to keep the Sabbath, keeping the Sabbath, there is a moral part based on creation. Agree? Merong moral part sa part ng creation. Kasi God told us, He made it holy. He rested on the seventh day. So, diba? So this is moral. This is demanded to all. This is demanded to all. That one of the 7 days, we must rest. We must keep it holy. And there is a civil part sa aspect na to on the Jewish calendar, which is relating to what I said kanina, the Sabbath being starting from Friday night hanggang sa gabi ng Sabado. So, ang nangyari, Christians move the day of worship to the Lord's Day. Ano ba yung the Lord's Day? The Lord's Day is actually in our current time, Sunday, which is, we celebrate yung Easter, the day of the Lord. This is the day when Jesus rose from the dead. So, they kept the principle or moral aspect of 1/7 days, but they were free to change the day, which was a uniquely Jewish element. So, ano ba yung explanation? Yung Sabbath is a command sa mga Jewish. It applies to them. But yung moral command sa creation, it applies to all. So yung Christians, they have the freedom to change yung day ng worship. So they kept the principle. So yun yung sinasabi dito. Sometimes it's difficult to detest from that command, yan ba ay moral, yan ba ay civil, yan ba ay ceremonial. So this is one example. Bakit merong ganun? Bakit merong ganun usapin? Na sometimes, di ba, we are confused, ano ba yung Sabbath day, ano ba yung day of rest, ano ba yung ating gagawin sa ating panahon? Why are we here on Friday? Di ba? Colossians 2 actually confirm this. Therefore, do not let anyone judge you by what you eat or drink, or with regard to a religious festival, a new moon celebration, or a Sabbath day. So meaning sa ating panahon, nobody can judge you about Sabbath day. Because God made it clear to us, we can choose the day we worship. So, we're not limited to Sunday, or Saturday, or Friday, being Sabbath, but we cannot be judged based on the Sabbath day. Or even go earlier, based on what you eat. Kasi yung pagkain, lahat na declare ng Lord na malinis. Right? So, we cannot be judged based on this. So, the ceremonial aspects of the Old Testament laws have been completed by Jesus on the cross. The civil aspects of the Old Testament law are meant for national or for the nation of Israel. The moral aspect of the law are for all times. This helps us understand why the New Testament speaks of the law in two different ways. That Christians are released from the law from the law. Yet the same author and the same books call us to obey clear commands from that law. Maliwanag po ba yung ating napag-uusapan? Yeah. Meron pong distinction, ano? Yeah. Today, because of Jesus Christ, we don't live in the world of Leviticus. So, yung pong panahon ng Leviticus ay nakalipas na. We don't live in that law. We are not subjected to that. Jesus' perfect self-sacrifice made the daily sacrifice of animals unnecessary. Hindi na po kailangan mag-atang o mag-alay ng hayop. It's no longer necessary. He replaced the high priest as our representative before God. Now, Jesus cleanses the real source of contamination, which is our sinful nature. So, Leviticus was meant to teach people some basic truths about God, and when their lessons were complete, they could go on to bigger and better things. Yet, we need to be reminded of the principles in Leviticus thought. It tells us that God was then, as He is today, a consuming fire. Ah, consuming fire. Kanina, we were just singing. I want to know your fire, di ba? I want to know more. God is a consuming fire. Why are we singing, set me ablaze? Di ba? Because God is a consuming fire that we wanted this fire to set us ablaze. He taught us how to live with that fire. Not because we deserve to know, but because He wanted our company. We dare not treat Him lightly in these regards. So, the next time someone starts saying that you are arbitrarily or randomly picking and choosing from the Bible, arm yourself with the civil, ceremonial, and moral distinction used by both Jews and Christians throughout the ages. Let me read these verses. Romans 7:1-3. Do you not know, brothers and sisters, for I am speaking to those who know the law, that the law has authority over someone only as long as that person lives. For example, by law, a married woman is bound to her husband as long as he is alive. But if her husband dies, she is released from that law that binds her to him. So then, if she has sexual relations with another man while her husband is still alive, she is called an adulteress. But if her husband dies, she is released from that law, and it's not an adulteress if she marries another man. Imagine, this is just one law. We have 613 of them in the Old Testament. So, my brothers and sisters, you also died to the law through the body of Christ, that you might belong to another, to him who was raised from the dead, in order that we might bear fruit for God. For when we were in the realm of the flesh, the sinful passions aroused by the law were at work in us, so that we bore fruit for death. But now, by dying to what once bound us, we have been released from the law, so that we serve in the new way of the Spirit, and not in the old way of the written law. So we are not being arbitrary when we quote the Bible verses, even if it's coming from the Old Testament, as long as you focus on the moral. You're being faithful by doing so, and you're reading the Old Testament the way Jesus and the New Testament teaches you to do. So, brothers and sisters, don't throw yet the Ten Commandments. Grab the Lord.
Thank you. Ayala, ni Elder Ronnie, sa mga bagay na dapat namin intindihin. Thanks and praise be to God for His life. The preaching is very simple. The only thing we need to know and understand is the law of God. Once we know, once we study from His Word, okay, that's the time we need to distinguish which law comes from where. Okay? It is ceremonial, it is judicial, or civil law, or the Jew, or it is a moral law. That's the only thing that we need to understand and to know. Without knowing the law of God, we cannot identify which law is it. So, from that law and from that understanding, pick the moral law and apply to our life. Amen?
Amen.
That's the only thing. Okay? If there is moral law in the judicial law of the Jewish, apply it to our life. Okay? Sabi nga sa kanyang salita, whichever is good, whichever is moral, whichever is right, do it for the glory of God.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So let us pray and let us apply what we learn and let's glorify God to all the things that we are doing. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for the word that we hear today that was preached to us by our Elder Ronnie. Let the Holy Spirit work in our life so that we can understand the message. And let the Holy Spirit help us also to search to your word so we understand better and we can distinguish which law or which moral law that we need to apply in our life. If we lack wisdom, we ask you, O God. We ask you to fill us with your wisdom, to give us your knowledge and understanding while we are searching your word. And let the Holy Spirit help us also to apply this in our life, not only in our life, but also use our life as a spiritual blessing for others. Okay? If we learn the moral law that we see in your word, let our life become a channel to teach others so that they can also glorify you. Okay? And make us a channel of blessing for others. Thank you. And patuloy po namin kayong itinataas. We glorify you. We magnify you. We praise you. And we love you, Father. Thank you for your faithfulness to us. Thank you for your love. Thank you for the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ that you gave to each of us to cleanse us and to save our life, Father. Thank you very much. Thank you for all. And ang lahat po ay itaas ang ating kamay. Let us all be blessed. May the God Himself, the God of peace, sanctify you through and through. May your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who called you is faithful, and He will do it. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Pray for the food. Lord, may spy na malapit
Panginoon about sa amin, sa aming mga narinig. Luwalatiin ka, gamitin mo yung mga lingkod, ang aming mga leader, ang aming mga elder, pastor, let them bless them according to your word, Panginoon. Salamat ng marami at misa pa, pagpalaan mo aming pagsasalusaluhan, ipapamagay sa aming mga buhay, sa aming mga kakainin. Luwalatiin ka, amin.